Hey, it is Kelsey Kors with Sweetfish Media, and welcome back to the new podcast series. Today, we're going to share with you a quick snippet from a new podcast we produce for our friends over at Pivot Point Security. It's called the Virtual CISO Podcast. This podcast provides frank discussions of the very best in information security advice and insights for security, IT, and business leaders. The host of this podcast is John Varie, and we get to tune in as he chats with industry leaders to ensure you have what you need to be confident in your security and compliance. If you think you'll find the show valuable after you check out this quick snippet, just search the Virtual CISO Podcast in Apple or your favorite podcast player. If this show isn't for you, but you know someone who could be interested, let them know. Whether that's a text message, a LinkedIn message, a phone call, or a smoke signal, any way you let them know is a good way. Make sure you subscribe, and if you really like it, don't forget to leave a review. Okay, let's jump into the snippet from John's very first episode.
I talk with business and technical leadership of probably a dozen-ish small to medium-sized enterprises each week, and they're all struggling notably with the same information security and privacy challenges. In some cases, unfortunately, they're really getting hurt by security events and breaches, the things you read about in the paper on an everyday basis or on the internet. Paper, I sound old. You know, at times, what I do can be pretty painful. I had a call last week as an example, small private wealth management firm, $480,000 moved out of a banking account by a hacker. You know, unfortunately, through a business email compromise, it was interesting. You know, unfortunately, it was too late to fix that issue. Fortunately, it was early enough to avoid another issue with this particular client. And the sad thing about that happening is that although information security is a very complex topic, it's not really that complicated. You know, it's basic risk management. So in the podcast, we're hoping to simplify the process, you know, simplify information security and privacy by elevating the conversation a bit, you know, taking it from bits and bytes and bringing it up a level to a point where we're bringing value to both a CIO and a CFO, or a CIO and a CTO, and a CIO and a COO. And we think that's going to help not only our customers, but of course, by helping our customers, we're helping their customers, right? Because we're keeping that data secure.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. The ripple effects of
exactly
greater security and management is going to be far beyond just that first touch.
Exactly. And if you think about it, a good information security conversation is one that resonates from the server room all the way to the boardroom, right? So if we can have that conversation that works in both places, then I think we've done our job. So if I summed it up in a perfect world, I'm hoping that this podcast allows us to change our conversations from a one-to-one to a one-to-many. That's going to make it easier for a broader audience to gain some perspective and learn to be proactive, right? To put in place a good security plan, so to speak, chart that course, and hopefully avoid these security incidents that are negatively impacting them and or their customers.
All right, everyone, we really hope you enjoyed that short clip from John. Remember, if you're looking for the latest strategies, tips, and trends from seasoned information security officers, want the no BS answers to your biggest security questions, or just simply want to stay informed and proactive, this is the podcast for you. John will keep you educated and perhaps even mildly entertained through topics like breach avoidance, incident response, dealing with those pesky security questionnaires, among other topics. Again, to find this show, just search the Virtual CISO Podcast in Apple Podcasts or wherever you do your listening. Subscribe, leave a review if you like it, and don't forget to tell a friend if you think they'd enjoy it. Think of it as security with a smile.
I hate it when podcasts incessantly ask their listeners for reviews, but I get why they do it. Because reviews are enormously helpful when you're trying to grow a podcast audience. So here's what we decided to do. If you leave a review for B2B Growth in Apple Podcasts and email me a screenshot of the review to james@sweetfishmedia.com, I'll send you a signed copy of my new book, Content-Based Networking, How to Instantly Connect with Anyone You Want to Know. We get a review, you get a free book. We both win.